Hi, I'm Sandi Genovese, and we are looking today at how to just take ordinary envelopes and turn them into the funnest little scrapbook that you've ever seen. Here you can see that the closure for the scrapbook is just a button. These remind me in the old days when I was really little, we used to have bank books that opened and closed like this. When you open it up, now you start to see that there's envelopes, and I've cut a little opening that makes it easy to pull a page out. And you pull it out, put all your photos, journaling, souvenirs, whatever you want, and then just slide it back in. And each of those flaps are tucked into the next envelope and fastened down with adhesive. So look at how great, until you get to the very end. I just did 6 envelopes for mine. And this is a strap, almost like a belly band, that we're going to wrap around. And then I just decorated right over it so that it gives the envelopes a little bit of play, so it stays nicely in this binding. This, obviously, you need to start with envelopes. Every time I go to Staples or Office Depot or any place, when I find envelopes that have this closure on the short end, I grab them because they are perfect for this. And you're going to find them in different dimensions, different sizes. So the size that you have will dictate the size of everything, but we'll go through the steps on how to build it. What I did was I had 3 that were green and 3 that were blue of these envelopes. And first I started by cutting. You want to cut the bottom off, and I wanted to be able to slide at least a 4x6 photo inside. This is just slightly bigger than 4 inches on the edge, on the width this way. So I cut it down so that it was 7 inches long when this flat part is closed. So I just went ahead and I cut the bottom of the envelope off, and then I want to look at how to make the finger tab. So what I did was I just took my circle punch, a really large circle punch, and I'm going to open up the envelope so it's kind of loose, because I'm only going to go through the top, and I'm going to slide this in like so. And then I'll go ahead and punch out that circle tab. You can see that the pencil mark that I had given myself kind of shows. So I'll go back and erase that. And that gives me the envelope. Then I'm going to go ahead and cut all the pages that are going to slide in. The key to making this binding is by folding the flaps back the opposite way. This is the way the envelope worked. I'm going to fold it this way. And then I'm going to take and I'm going to attach all these envelopes together. So if you look at this, is going to be the first page. Remember I said I have 6, so here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is going to be page 1. So I'm going to take this flap that's already folded backwards and slide it into the opening of the envelope. I'm going to go back and add adhesive, but I thought I'd first just start by showing you. So normally I'll put adhesive here and slide this together. You end up, every one of these pages are just slid in like that. And I'm going to go back and add adhesive. This is going to give me everything that I need in order to create this really cool binding mechanism. So let me stop for a minute. I'm not going to put adhesive on this page yet, but I'm going to go ahead and put adhesive on the other pages. And the adhesive does not go where the old adhesive was. I want this to stick here to this page. So I'm going to go ahead and put my adhesive here. And then slide it in, and when it's all lined up, go ahead, close the page, and press. And then I'm just going to keep doing that. I'm going to pull out and keep doing the rest of the pages. So right now I'm just sliding in the last page. I'm going to close, make sure they're all aligned, and then press. So when I go back and I show you, it's the same thing, but now the pages have actually been fastened together with adhesive. what I need to do now is attach it into the cover, and we need to first look at making the cover. So if you look at mine, at the finished one, you'll see the front cover, it's all attached in one long strip, and I'll show you in a minute, but it needs to be long enough that it needs to be the same length or a hair, just a hair longer than your envelope. And then the spine, I've allowed a half inch, the same matching length to the front, another half inch binding, and then this flap. To be honest, I started with 11/17 cardstock, and I cut it down so that it's just about a little more, since my envelopes are 4 inches, you can see that I have just a little bit of breathing room, so it's just maybe 4 1/16. So, and then it's 17 inches long, and so it allows me, my half inch spine is 7 inches, and then the half inch, and then 7 inches, the half inch, and then my overlap. So I'm going to put my adhesive here and attach this, but I think it's a little bit easier to decorate the cover before everything is inside here. So I'm going to put this aside for just a minute, and I won't stop to decorate the whole thing, but I'll put a few of the elements in there so you kind of get the idea, and it will look similar to what I started with, and you can see how easily it will go together. So this will be for the front cover, starting at the spine, and fasten that down, and then come back with a green with some white embossed dots for the next layer. And I'm going to line this up with the end and with the sides. And of course, the dimensions are going to just be based on the look and what you want. You need to remember that this is going to fold over, so this is what you're really going to see. And then I won't stop to do it, but you would fasten this down and a heart or whatever other embellishments. I do want to stick this down because this is going to have to happen before we attach the button. So I'm going to go ahead and place my adhesive on the strip that's going to be for the overlapping flap. And I'll go ahead and line this up with the edges. And one of the reasons for building this before you have everything inside is it's easy now. You don't have all those pages. If you needed to go back and trim, if something, in fact, that is sticking out just a little bit. So let me just trim off this little lip here so that from the back side it still looks good. So go ahead and add the decoration that you want to this cover. Keep going for as much embellishment as you want. And then when it's time to put the pages inside, then all you need to do is place adhesive on this one exposed flap that's left, that for me is the front cover. So I'm going to go ahead and place my adhesive on the flap, and this time it is going on the sticky side. And for some reason I could not find an adhesive. Maybe wet glue would work. It doesn't want to stick to those sections. Well, there it is a little. So if it's not sticking, I would add like a zot or double stick tape onto those little sections just to make sure that it's going to stick. So I'm going to align everything in here so it's inside and my spine is all in the right place. Lay this over the top, make sure everything is nice and straight, and then I'll go ahead and press down. So you can see I've got my flap fastened down. I'm going to just add additional pressure with my fingers to make sure that it's nicely stuck to that edge. And I can do the same thing when I close it this way and really push as well. So now what I have are all the pages inside. And the only thing is it's not attached at the back. You can glue this down, but then this sometimes makes it hard, I think, to use this last page. If you took the card out and you fastened this down, it's kind of hard to get this last page out. So what I prefer to do is to just create this flap. The width of this doesn't matter because you're going to decorate it, but just take a piece of that same 11/17 cardstock, wrap it around. There's no adhesive going to go here. This is going to let this open and close and slide freely. Where the adhesive is going to go is when you get around to the back side. So I'm going to put adhesive to close this up. So let me go ahead and put my adhesive on here. And on, I'm going to just line this up with the fold line. Making sure that I clear the spine itself. And then put my adhesive here. I got to turn this in order to get to this adhesive spot. So then pull this around and fasten down. So it's attached to the back, and I will go back now and put another color over the top. I'll show you on my finished one in a minute, but see how it allows this to move freely. It gives it the play. It just keeps the integrity of the whole thing together nicely, and it keeps everything perfectly in place. When it comes time to put the button, that actually was, I think, maybe the easiest part. All I did was I took my button and I threaded embroidery thread through both of the holes and just pulled it through, leaving a long length. But then I used foam adhesive, and I'm going to pull my thread this direction. So if I take, I'll do my tweezers so you can see, I'm going to pull off the backing and I'm going to just turn this like so and fasten this down in the middle somewhere of this section and press. And when I press on that, that's going to hold the button. But now it's also, because the embroidery thread is trapped inside, now it's going to hold that too. So that when I wrap this around, all I need to do is wrap here. And if I want to go through here and tie a knot or add beads any way that I want to, you can see how it's really starting to look just like the finished one. So here you can see, same thing. I've just gone back and I've started to add embellishments just as if they were scrapbook pages. Nobody even needs to know that these were envelopes, but it's just a fun little scrapbook. Goes together easily, and I said I would show you. Here you can see I've just used paper, but when you fasten your decorative paper to that final section, let me go to that page and show you. You want to be sure that you only attach it to this strip. Don't attach it to the tag. You want this to slide, be able to slide in and out easily. So it's only attached to my strap that went around, and the strap in this instance was fatter. It doesn't really matter how skinny or how fat it is. Who knew that envelopes, ordinary envelopes, would so easily convert into such a special little scrapbook?